PTT, a Thai energy and oil and energy giant, teaming up with Foxconn to make EVs. On the surface, it seems like, is it a case of, look, if you can't beat them, join them?
Yes. Good morning, Mattis. Since we announced the deal last year, there are a lot of progress both the government policy and the PTT development path. First, the government announced the EV3 program to accelerate the EV demand as production in Thailand. They give the tax incentive for the EV such as they reduce the import tax and they reduce the excise tax for create the demands. And PTT and right now PTT have to join the Foxconn. We are finished to set up the JV company for the EV OEM production in Thailand.
Yeah, and Khun Puttin, I know you're going to be investing up to $2 billion in an EV factory in eastern Thailand. Specifically, which site?
Ah, yes. Okay, I think the right now we are in the process to have the site selection. We aim to locate it in the Eastern Economic Corridor. Is like Chonburi, Rayong is near our marine port.
Ah, it makes sense because, I mean, when you say the name Rayong, that is also the site where a lot of conventional car manufacturing takes place. And the reason why, I mean, Thailand has become known as sort of the Detroit of Asia.
Yes, yes, correct. Because in the Eastern Seaboard, they have a lot of the ICE spare parts, and we is a quality with the marine port. It's easy to import of the spare part and export of our the EV car.
Khun Puttin, where are you going to get your batteries from?
For the batteries is in on the process because the parts of the battery, the cell line and the cell pack is very important for the cost of the EV. Right now we talk about the Foxconn and we talk about the some battery company to invest in the Thailand for the cell pack. But we have our subsidiary, the GPSC and PTT set up the new company is named the New Overpass to develop the battery supply for the EV car.